G'day. Today we're changing out the clock spring on this 2007 Toyota Hilux. Usually you know you've got a bad clock spring when your horn doesn't work, you've got an airbag light, your audio controls or your cruise control don't work. The clock spring's usually the issue. The clock spring controls all of those functions via a coiled up wire that only gives you 2.5 turns in either direction. They can go bad for other reasons, but mostly it's because the steering wheel has been allowed to turn more than 2.5 turns in one direction or another. In my case, someone, myself, removed the steering rack and the steering wheel has moved and it's broken the clock spring. But that's okay, we'll change it out. Procedure's pretty similar for most cars and especially for most Toyotas, which is the same idea, but you do have to be careful with the airbag. The first thing we're gonna do is isolate the battery, make sure everything's dead, and then I'll show you how to remove the airbag and we'll get to the clock spring underneath the steering wheel. As you can see, we've got an airbag light there, no horn, and cruise control doesn't work. So we're looking at a broken clock spring. It's just behind the steering wheel here. We'll get the airbag off and we'll have a look. All right, so we've isolated the battery. We're gonna make sure that it's dead. We're gonna need a socket to get the steering wheel off. I believe it's a 19 mil. We need the clock spring. I've got a secondhand one there. We need some Torx bits to get the cover of the steering wheel off. And hopefully we don't need a steering wheel puller, but we've got one if we need. Very important that the steering wheel is centered here. We're going to be taking the steering wheel off. We want to have a reference point in which to put it back on, or else we'll be breaking another clock spring usually. So steering wheel comes off centered, goes back on centered as well. Okay, we've confirmed everything's dead. Nothing works, which is good. We'll get this horn pad off. We're going to need a Torx bit and we're going to come in from the back here on both sides. We're going to take this cover off. All right, these are T30s, I believe. And there's one on each side of the steering wheel. So we just wind them out and then we can pull this horn pad off and have a look at the wires for the airbag. They can be a little bit stuck in there. You have to sort of work them out because they sit inside a hole. Awfully weird. There we go. Okay, so this is our airbag switch here. We just need to pull this yellow section up and then we can pull that off and it doesn't explode on us, hopefully. Okay, with that popped, we can pull that out. There's also a horn on there on the bottom. Pull that little horn off and then we pull the whole airbag away without it going bang. Now we'll store that safely and we'll pull the steering wheel off. Okay, so we've got a 19 mil socket. That wasn't very tight. Leave the nut on, and if you just grab the steering wheel and you give it a, make sure it's centered as before, give it a good pair of these, and they should come off. If not, you've got to use a puller. There are threads in here that'll help you pull it off, but give it a good shake like this. You can normally get it off the taper all right. Like I said, make sure it stays centered. Behind here, we do have the clock spring, so we'll get this off. Let the wires go through for the cruise control and the horn, and we'll get to the clock spring. Okay, steering wheel came off. We had a little plug here for the cruise control. This is our clock spring here, what's left of my one. Just gonna take these two off, drop this, and we should be able to undo the clock spring itself to change it out. Okay, so there's two clips under here behind all the red dirt and husky hair that's in my ute all the time. If we push these two down, we should be able to just pop this out. One, that's the second one there. This bottom plug here on the old clock spring has a slide on it. You can just see if you get in there, you have to slide it across and remove the plug that way. It's on a spring. It's a very odd thing I've never seen before, but there you go. Just slide that off, get that out of the way. This other one is just a standard plug. Everybody's happy there. And go ahead and remove the rest of the clock spring from there. Now there is one more little clip at the top here. I've taken this top shield out to have a look. Just got to get under it. Cool, so that's your three. One, two, three, hold it in. Two plugs, and that's it there. They do have a number, five on them, for five turns. And they have a little window here that'll actually tell you when they're centered. This one is cooked, so it's not going to tell you that. But the new one, or at least my replacement one, does have a little window here, and you can see the little orange thing to see that we are centered. Now, when you get a brand new one, they'll have a locking tab in here to make sure that it's bang on center, and they're actually designed, you hook them and you break them off. You can see it's here, and even my factory original one has it there. It is designed to break off. It's a one-use item, so make sure you break that off and get it out of the way. We're going to fit this one in here, cut this cable tie here, and we're good to go again. And that's the inside of it there. If you're interested, it's actually broken just there. That should be connected to the plug down there. It winds around these wheels, and that's your clock spring. Pretty simple, but easy to break. All right, replacement clock spring's in there. I'm happy it's still centered. I've had to cut the cable tie to make it fit. Usually you'd have a pull break here. I'm just going to plug the yellow one straight back in here underneath. Make sure it goes all the way on. It should click. There we go. That's the bottom one there. This is going to go through the steering wheel. Now this can turn, but we know here's our center point. We're happy with that. We'll put our top half back on as well. Let's chuck this in. There we go, it goes right anyway. Okay. So happy that's all back in. Got two screws back in. Cool. Our wheel can go back on. Now we need to get our cruise control plugged into the top here, and our horn is going to just hook around here, and it's part of the same plug, so we're all good. And you see how these screws will hold you up trying to get it out, and they just hold in there. Just got to wiggle, wiggle to get them out. Push this through here without turning our clock spring too much. We want to keep everything perfectly centered. Find that spline. There it is. Cool, everything lined up nicely. That's good. And the horn comes in and just hooks under this plastic section here before going into the back of the horn pad. That goes into the bottom of the horn pad. Not too many dramas. Whack our nut back on and we'll torque that up as well. Torque wrench, we'll torque that up. Okay, I've just engaged the steering lock, and we're going to put 50 newton meters of torque on this nut. I'll show you a longer socket. There we go, 50 newton meters. Take the steering lock back off. Cool, steering wheel's centered, happy with that. Nut is torqued. We can now fit the airbag pad again. We're about done. Okay, so we've got an airbag pad. Fit the horn at the bottom. And very carefully and with lots of kindness, plug this back in. Just got to lift a little yellow thing up here. Just plug that in there. There we go. Yellow thing goes in to make sure it's locked. We really want to make sure that's connected. If you're having a crash, you want that to work. Cool, that's all connected up. We just drop it in, make sure the wires aren't touching anything they shouldn't be. Everything's happy and out of the way. All right, we'll just push that back in and put the screws in. Okay, so now we just put this back in and get them screws back into their positions. And grabbing our little Torx bit again, tighten them back up. And that is all changed out. That's all done. That's the old one there gone. New one's in there. Happy days. If you didn't isolate your battery, which you probably should have, you may need to reset the airbag light through a scan tool, but usually battery on, battery off will reset it anyway, and it should fix the airbag light with the new clock spring. Mine did. That's it. Thanks for watching.